Good evening and welcome to this edition of the County Connection. I'm your host, County Commissioner Kevin Barnhardt. We have a pretty exciting program this evening. It's an annual event that takes place every April here at the Berks Leisure Field. And it's a combination of Healthy Kids Day, YMCA Healthy Kids Day, and Go Fly a Kite Day, which is part of our Parks and Recreation Department. And I have tonight two of the instrumental folks in putting all this and planning this together. It takes at least a year. It's almost like planning a wedding reception. No sooner you're done with Healthy Kids Day, Go Fly a Kite Day, you're planning for it already the next day. I have to my left, your immediate right, Dory Bernstein, the HR director at the YMCA. And to my far left, your right, is Michelle Reinhart. She's the Development and Marketing Director for the YMCA. Good evening, ladies.
Hello. Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
And they were so nice to pull together a PowerPoint, because we know how impactful it is when you look at a PowerPoint and you really get that information. We're really going to emphasize often tonight how important this is for our kids in the community, how exciting this is, and how many years it's been taking place. We really want everybody to come out Saturday, April 27th, rain or shine, to the Youth Recreation Field in Bern Township. So we really want to encourage more people. We've had thousands come out, but there's plenty of room. There's acres and acres of opportunity for people to really enjoy. And each year it gets bigger and better, right, ladies?
Yes. It does. This is my third year chairing, fourth year that we've been partnered with Berks County Parks and Rec. And just the growth in the last 3 years is amazing. And like you said, as soon as we get done with it, I get calls the next day. How can we get partnered up? How can we participate next year? So it's a lot of fun starting that work each year.
And we actually have always had great weather. A little windy sometimes for the kites, but it's amazing. Yes. Sometimes you can have too much wind for kites,
right.
But never thought that when I was a kid. But yes, you can.
You can. But no, we have. And actually, you had mentioned Healthy Kids Day. It's actually a national initiative through YMCAs, and there will be about 14,000 events going on that Saturday across the nation.
It's amazing.
And it's actually gotten to the point where we have a theme for it each year, Awaken the Summer Imagination. It is our way of launching summer programming, and it's a way for us to introduce to the community, to families, what we have going on, not just at the YMCA, but in Berks County.
Sure. And you can't do it without partners, right?
No.
You have some huge partners, if you want to explain that, and then we can go into part of the PowerPoint. So people really recognize how it has to be pulled together. You need volunteers. You need the YMCA as the backbone, but you also need sponsors to really make this thing happen, because you can't do a lot of these things without the support of the community and the sponsors.
Yeah. I'm definitely going to defer to Michelle on that. This has been her introduction to Healthy Kids Day this year with the Y, and she has really taken on that lead and that challenge of reaching out to sponsors and really has done a great job.
We definitely want to thank Tower Health and the UPMC Health Plan for jumping on board as a presenting sponsor. This is, if I'm correct, the third year in a row now that they have been our major or presenting sponsor. And it's really important to have an organization like that who is all about health and wellness over the longevity of your life from the time you're born until you actually, you know, need them for medical care. So for them to be part of this is a huge deal. And then they also bring other partners and collaborators with them. So it allows us to have 30 to 40 some vendors there who are able to do different health screenings and talk about different things, whether it's BMI or sugar or diabetes, and we can fit all of that into the day and caring for the family while you're out having a good time.
And this isn't just restricted to children. This is
correct
for all ages, but it's really kind of encouraged the parents to bring the kids out. And there's a lot of fun and games, but there's also some serious things, healthy eating, healthy lifestyle, and certain tests to go on with it as well.
Right. And each year we try to build off of what is currently being seen in our communities as areas of development, opportunities where we can do better as families, as educators, as community activists. And we bring together those activities and all of those groups under one essential umbrella. Mm-hmm. And kids get the full gamut. Families get to talk to practitioners. They get to talk to activities and martial artists and kite flyers. Mm-hmm. And they learn that, wow, we have a lot going on here in Berks County that support a healthy lifestyle, not just for kids, but for our whole families. And I can't say enough, this year we are excited to be bringing a sensory field in. We have not done that in the past. We recognized that it was an area that we were limited in. So we reached out and we are working with the Autism Society. And we are starting small scale, so we will have a dedicated field for everybody, not just somebody who feels that they have that need, but it is for everybody so we can educate our communities, our kids, our families on what's available and you know, learn some new techniques. Mm-hmm. So that's really exciting this year. I'm proud to say that.
First.
Bringing it.
Of many years that you can have the sensory field.
Oh, yeah. Yes. And I expect it to just blossom, as well as some other areas that we don't even know that we're not tapping into until somebody brings it to us.
Right. So people that attend come back and say, it was great. What do you think about having this?
Right.
And
you're
more than willing to try it. Again, in the beginning of the program, I said how large the place is. And I don't want to leave without congratulating Dan Clouser.
Oh my gosh.
Who manages the fields for the County of Berks.
Yep.
He's been at this for about 7 or 8 years. He opens up the gates, makes this really available. Otherwise, he could be having baseball tournaments.
Right.
But he's dedicated this Saturday for Healthy Kids Day. So that's a tribute to Dan Clouser and Big Vision Baseball for allowing, he could be making money, but now he turns it over and says, here, this is for the community. So kudos go out to Dan Clouser and his team.
Absolutely, and they do a great, I couldn't ask for a better partner in facilities. And then they also do a home run derby contest for two different age groups. So please, if you have a baseball player who's interested, he runs it according to the bylaws and regulations of National Home Run Derby contest, and then those winners go on to compete further.
So you have quite a list here. If we can go back to the Who's at Healthy Kids Day 2019. These are all the various supporters, vendors, sponsors. So if you want to highlight some of them for the audience.
I think some of the ones like Elite Leadership Martial Arts has been a partner and sponsor for several years now. And that's just a great group. And they'll do a demo at 1 o'clock that day in addition to the activity that they have going on. So what's really neat about the way this is set up is everyone that participates has a particular game or activity that's set up at their station. So in addition to answering questions, whether they're educational or physical or they're from a health perspective, there's something to do at each table. So it garners the interest of the children while mom and dad have an opportunity to talk to them and find out more about them and what they do.
And let me jump in right there, Michelle. In the kids will receive a passport, and that passport will have logos from each of these participants on. And as they stop by the tables, they get a check mark or a stamp, and then turn that in at the end of the day for some raffle prizes.
Okay, ladies, I know what a pony ride is, but you have to tell me what a date with a tramp is and what a Zumbini with Shayla is.
Okay.
So, Date with a Tramp is actually being brought in by our partners at Berks County Park for part of the Let's Go Fly a Kite Festival.
Okay.
So, it's actually a trampoline, an oversized trampoline that they can do some activities on. In addition to that, they're bringing in Orbitron and also a blow-up life-size Jacob's Ladder.
Wow.
So, what's neat about this is in those goodie bags that Dory was mentioning, each child will get a ticket and they'll be able to do one of those activities for free. So they'll be able to check it out, and then if they want to do one of the other ones, they'll have to hit mom and dad up for a small fee.
Yep.
But that'll be there the duration of the day. So
it must make you feel good that people just come in and say, can we participate next year? Can we bring something in? It's a great idea. Mm-hmm. It's a great place, and we'd like to bring our attraction there. And Zumbini with Shayla.
Zumbini with Shayla. This is a new sponsor for us. It is a music with babies and kids and preschoolers. I have not witnessed it yet, but my guess is that it's music and Zumba, but with kids and families.
Okay.
So it's geared towards those larger motor skills and things.
And physical activity.
Yes.
Right.
That's what we're trying to promote is physical activity, healthy lifestyles. Get off the couch, get out from behind the computer, and have a great day. We always control the weather at the county, so we'll make sure it's 75 and wind gust of 5 to 8 miles an hour.
How's that?
Plenty of sunshine.
Perfect.
Returning attractions. Next slide, emergency vehicles. You want to go in? We have, what, over 15 this year?
15 so far.
Today.
Kids love emergency vehicles.
Yep.
Yep. Yeah, we have everything from unmarked police cars to an engine to a tanker to a scuba truck. My favorite is going to be the mobile crime scene unit, which is housed in one of the ambulances. That's where I'll be if anyone's looking for me that day. But yeah, so 15 total emergency vehicles, which is great. So the kids will have an opportunity to not only check out those vehicles, but also read with an officer while they're there. Then they get to vote on their favorites, and then we'll pass along a trophy for bragging rights until next year.
The officers normally have like trading cards, cards with their picture on and their time on the force and their motivational thing. That's great for kids to start to understand law enforcement.
Right.
And what it really means in the community. I think we've gotten away from that. I think we need to start anything like this to bring kids to law enforcement, understand there are friends out there.
Right.
Absolutely. And, you know, just taking away the fear, the scaredness of somebody new, somebody in a uniform, that this is a really good event for them to develop an experience. I also want to add to the returning attractions. So the YMCA, we have a whole field dedicated to our summer camp programs. We have counselors there, we have program directors there, we have volunteers, and we have different activities set up that really replicate what a day is like in summer camp. So kids can come out, do arts and crafts. Parents can meet some of the directors and camp counselors. So again, that first day of summer camp isn't scary. It's exciting. They know what to expect. They can register. Our last day for our early bird pricing is at Healthy Kids Day. So we will have registrations at our table. And we can answer any questions regarding what the summer plans look
like. I'm sure the viewers may not know how many YMCA branches are involved in this, how far out in the community they extend, and how many kids basically come to the Y throughout a year.
Oh, wow. Our summer camp programs, our summer camp program usually levels out at about 1,000 over the summer. We have six branches, one as far as Tamaqua in Schuylkill County, and then we have Adamstown, Mifflin, Sinking Spring, Fleetwood, and Center City Reading. And they all have different summer programs, playground programs, and pool operations all summer long. And then that's in addition to the activities that go on all year long, too.
Amazing. So we have the next slide is pony rides, right?
Pony rides.
Pony rides are great. We have a returning group that comes every year and offers pony rides. We strategically place them so that we draw traffic to all corners of the park while we're there.
So they do their business in a certain corner, though.
Yep, right? No worries.
Okay, no worries.
I think you guys control that too, right?
Uh-huh, that's right.
Okay.
And we had mascots as well. We have some mascots lined up to come out this
I hope
year.
So. It always gets tricky depending on playoffs and games and things going on, whether or not they'll be able to get out to us, but they always try and get there. We had Screwball there last year, and we're hoping to see him again this year.
So, passports. Dory, you mentioned him earlier. So, parents come out. What's the time they should get there on Saturday, April 27th?
They can come anytime after 10 o'clock. We open at 10 to 4. Registration will be under the big striped tent, I think.
First tent
Tent you see at the top. But we will have a second registration area this year, too, because we did have some traffic come in from the softball fields. And they will get a sling backpack that will be full of all kinds of goodies, some healthy snacks, the passport, some other flyers and materials of information of what's going on this summer. I do want to point out, I think our next slide is the Summer Learning Fund 211. So the United Way has a Summer Learning Coalition initiative, and part of that, and the YMCA is part of that coalition, as are many of the vendors and sponsors and participants of this event. And our goal is to really get that information in a place where parents know where to look. And 211 is our method of retaining that information. So all the programs in Berks County are being encouraged to get their information added into 211. Dial 211, give them your zip code, the age of your kids, and they can let you know exactly what's available program-wise. You can also text that service, too.
It's a telling message at the bottom. 6 weeks of school are utilized every year, relearning a month's worth of material due to summer learning loss.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Fight summer slide, dial 211. Yep. And this is getting, end of April gets pretty close to when kids start to, you know, things are starting to slow down, I guess. They're taking their finals.
They are.
They're taking their tests, and they're starting to look out the window toward the end of May, and out the door they go in June.
Me too. So, yes. I have to do this when I come back, too.
That's a whole philosophy of what's better, taking a summer break or actually having school all year. That debate can continue, I guess. I guess years and years and years ago, they gave kids off because of the heat. They gave kids off in the summer because of working in the farms.
Right.
But as we progress as a society, maybe that's something that needs to be looked at again. I know in areas where relatives of mine went to school in Florida, as well as in New Jersey, one was they had year-round school in Florida, which I thought was more impactful. Mm-hmm. They would take longer gaps between Christmas and like spring break. And then when I was a young person, my cousins went to school in North Jersey, but that was a overcrowding situation. Okay. They literally went, one of them went from 6 to 12 in the morning, the other one went from 12 to 6 at night, and they went on Saturdays.
Wow.
Because
wow,
they were so overcrowded in school, but they went year-round.
Yeah. So, as a parent, I enjoy a summer vacation for about 7 days, and then I'm like, when do you go back to school? Isn't that time? But just to reiterate, that is the focus of this group, and the summer 211 really is just in response to parents saying, I don't know what's available for my kids. So
kids start to get bored too after a while, and you have to keep them motivated and pushing down, because most kids want to learn. Most kids want to be engaged and learn and grow. And that this is really important. I want to spend some more time on this than we did on some of the other slides, because it's very important. Okay. So then the next one, we have kids fingering up the police car, right? I guess the officer is going to take that through the car wash when he's done, but that's pretty neat.
They love it. And there are a few sirens, and they do get to do a couple bells and whistles now and then as they're reading. I think that's how they try to get more votes. By letting the kids do that.
So then the next one is so many cars. This is at least our initial lineup of the first responders who will be there, between police officers, fingerprinting, I guess, mobile crime vans. And the first year, I believe we pulled this together, we had some motorcycles.
We did.
And I don't know if the police departments have as many motorcycles as they did in the past. Maybe that's the reason, but I don't think all of them have motorcycles.
And I think they're trying to show off their biggest and their most interesting vehicle. The one, like Michelle said, crime scene? Everybody's like, what?
Maybe they'll bring out some canines. You never know. There's still some time. It's, what is today, April 8th? So we have basically almost 3 weeks still. Some could decide at the last minute to get some even more exciting things than we already have. Mm-hmm. So that's a great turnout by the first... The first responders really appreciate their support, too, and that grows every year, too.
And that's what I wanted to say. I really, really wanted to take an opportunity to thank the law enforcement, the emergency service vehicles, all of these groups, not just for coming out on the 27th and supporting us, but to offer our support to them for what they do every single
every day.
Yep. And next slide, new to Healthy Kids Day 2019, sensory field. Music therapy, podcasting, and social media ambassadors.
Yes, this is, so we do a really good job of attracting younger kids. We wanted to look at what's exciting and interesting to that 11 to 15 year old kid group. And with the library, the Reading Public Library has their new vehicle that is hooked up to the internet. It's a technology vehicle. And in talking to them, one of the things that we said is we could do some podcasting and do some recording at the event and really kind of go into that next level event again. So podcasting and social media ambassadors kind of go hand in hand. We are looking for kids that age. We will be putting some contest announcements up on the Facebook page soon that we would like to have some kids try out to be our social media ambassadors for the day.
I want to throw this out there. Is 10 to 4 enough time for all that you have taking place?
We're going to need a lot of volunteers, please.
Wow. 10 to 4 and a lot to cover.
Yes.
Yep. Sensory activities, Autism Society of Berks.
Yes.
Very important slide to cover.
It is. They are so excited, and they have been such ambassadors for us in getting the word out. They're excited to be a part of it. We are learning so much. They are the experts in this field, mm-hmm. so we are really just kind of handing them the keys to one of the fields and letting them set up. Dan has been very generous in mm-hmm. letting them do rice tables, water tables, and all those kinds of things that are important to their programs. So definitely check out. That's for everybody, too.
We wish we had more time, but we have 2 quick minutes.
Yep.
So let's don't miss these events. If you want to run through, Michelle, real quick,
sure.
the timeline so everybody knows they can mark their calendars.
Yep. So at 12 o'clock, we'll do the proclamation down in front of the Home Run Derby field. And then the Red Creek Wildlife will have a raptor demonstration at 12 p.m. and 1 p.m. Loud 99.3 will be broadcasting live from 12 to 2. Zumbini with Shayla will have a performance at 12 and then again at 4. Elite Leadership Martial Arts will do their demonstration at 1. The kite contest will be off and on throughout the afternoon. And then the candy drops will to be announced or determined depending on wind.
And all of this information, real quick, it will be available on the Facebook page, and there will be a QR code that people can scan with their smartphones, and then they can carry the information with them through
Great.
The day.
So we covered a lot of territory again. Saturday, April 22nd, 27th, yeah. 10 to 4, Youth Recreation Fields, Burn Township. Come one, come all. Free, open to the public. And as we close, I'd like to go through our last 2 or 3 slides with our sponsors. We can't thank them enough for their dedication and support to Healthy Kids Day, Go Fly a Kite Day. And thank you. And for this edition of County Connection, I want to thank my friends here, Dory and Michelle, for spending
Thanks.
Time with me tonight and really promoting something that is truly a gem and a treasure here in Berks County.
Thanks for having
thank
us.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
We'll take an hour next year.
Okay.
Okay.
Sounds like a plan.